people ask me all the time, what's the best business with this budget, or what's the best business period in my opinion? And my answer is always the same. The best business is doing whatever it is you like to do. Maybe if I show some people that, it'll make a little more sense. What's up, hustlers? It's your boy JTS, who's back again with another video. And have you ever wondered if rooms in your house could actually make you a little bit more money? Well, I'm going to find out for myself. Let's get into it.
I'm disappointed. Giving you the blueprint to get it out here, and you don't want to do what it takes.
All right, hustlers, so I'm not talking about Airbnb in your home or renting out rooms in your home. All of those are great ideas, but I did a poll on the community tab. If you're not checking out what's going down on the community tab on this channel, you need to start checking it out. These are the results right here, and I've decided to transform my laundry room into some sort of room that can actually make me just a little bit of extra money. Now, I ran the numbers. To go to the laundromat, it will only cost me around 20 to 40 bucks a month, okay? Just depends on how many times I change clothes and things of that nature. But I'm spending no more than $40 a month if I go to the local laundromat, do a few loads of laundry, instead of maintaining a washer and dryer here. So, what I've decided to do is to actually turn my laundry room into a room that could possibly make me a little bit of passive income, either through 3D printing or through fish breeding. I have experience with keeping fish, not a whole lot of experience with breeding fish, but it is something that I always wanted to give a shot, and I do feel confident that I'll have a lot of success with. Now, what I personally was going to do is do both of these things in the room. I was going to do the 3D printing business first, since you guys voted in favor of that being the first business. But I had a good friend of mine who has decided to invest in me transforming my laundry room into a room that will make me just a little bit of extra money. But they would like for me to do the fish breeding business first. So, without further ado, I am now about to get rid of this laundry room and make it a room that can just make me passive income. But stay tuned to the end of this video, because I'm going to get rid of this washer and dryer and give it away to one of you guys. All right, hustlers, so these washers and dryers don't really look like much. Actually, the washing machine just fills up with water and doesn't work. It doesn't do anything if it fills up with water. Dryer works fine, but it's just not very pretty. But don't worry, I'm going to take these out. We're going to get them fully restored, and one of you guys are going to get them. But now, let me get to work. Complete this breeder tank. Now, what the biggest takeaway that I want you to gain from watching this video is that the best business for you to start is start a business out of whatever it is you like to do. I've been keeping fish since 2012. I kept a whole variety of fish, but I've never tried to breed fish, but this has been something that I always wanted to try to do. Now, maybe you're into clothes, you should sell clothes. You're into sneakers, sell sneakers. If you're into fish, you can breed and sell fish, you can open up a fish shop. The problem that a lot of new aspiring entrepreneurs face is that they are working a job that they hate, So they really want to get out of there. So they quit that job and then start a business that they don't really like just because of the money. Or they work in a job that maybe they don't hate, but there's just not any money in it. So they quit that job. But then again, instead of starting a business out of something that they like, they end up doing something that they don't know anything about, something that they hate to do. In my opinion, the best first business for anybody to start is to take whatever your hobby is and make that into a business. Now, am I saying that whatever your hobby is going to make you six figures or $1 million? Absolutely not. I have no idea of knowing what all of you guys' favorite hobby is. But what I will tell you is that regardless of how big or how small your hobby is, you can make that into a business. And the things that you learn in that business will be transferable into larger businesses. Let me give you some examples. Let's say that this fish tank and this fish breeding business was my very first entrepreneurial venture ever. And I was going to get into this because I love fish and I'm working a job now that I hate. Well, some things that I will learn from breeding fish is, how in the world do you market fish to sell? How in the world do you ship fish? How do you pay taxes on a fish business? Where am I going to get inventory from? And it's things like this that once you learn how to do it, you can apply that over to other businesses. So once you learn how to legally set up a fish breeding business, then you'll know this is how you get a business license for anything. How to get an LLC, how do you set up a business bank account, how do you find customers and market to them, where do you get supplies from, how do you figure out a break even, and all of those things that are very important to small business owners if you want to be successful long term. Now, the good thing about taking something that you love and making that a business is that you're more likely to stick it out because it's something that you already like to do. For example, once I get these fish in, let's say that I can't get the fish to breed for whatever reason, or it takes a really long time to get them to breed. And then after they breed, how do I find people that's willing to buy these fish? Because I'm not breeding goldfish or any common fish. The fish that I'm trying to breed are on the market right now for between $200 to $500 in a lot of places. And the quality that I want to develop and maintain, I'm trying to make a fish that's worth at least $250 and up, depending on how much success I have. And that is for a single fish, which I know a lot of you guys that are not into aquariums and fish and things of that nature, that may sound crazy, but believe it or not, there are people out there that are selling one single fish for $1,000 or more, and you can't eat the fish. Again, it's just about knowing your market. So by doing something that you love, you already got an idea of the market. If I have trouble at any point with the breeding business, I'm not doing this business just for the money. Honestly, turning this laundry room into something that creates a passive cash flow for myself is something that I personally think is very dope. And me being able to do that with something that I also really care about, which is keeping pet fish, really makes this a win-win for me. So I don't have to make $1,000 my first day with this fish breeding business. I don't have to make $1,000 honestly my first year with this business either, which is another thing too. Once you start a business out of something that you love, you're going to keep doing it regardless. You're not going to be super dependent on the money. And I do recommend, if you can, don't give up your normal stream of income to start off your very first business. I do understand that some people have to do that, and I'll be honest with you, I did that in the beginning. But there are a lot of you out there that will have the option of staying with whatever your current source of income is until you figure out how to get your business built up so that it makes enough money. Can you be successful if you go all in? Absolutely. I'm proof of that, but I want you to know that you gotta have very thick skin. You gotta be able to roll with the punches. Things might get very bad for a while before they get very good, and that's just true of entrepreneurship, especially in the beginning. But I hope you guys got value out of this. If anybody cares about fish keeping and fish breeding and things of that nature, put it in the comment section. I may continue to do these type of videos, but I'm going to assume that this is not something that the majority of you guys really care about. So I won't really do a lot of updates on this, but I did want to share this initial idea with you guys, because the question I get all the time is, what's the greatest business to start? And I really feel like there isn't one business that's greater than all other businesses. Now, can you make a lot of money in real estate? Yes. Can you make a lot of money in tech? Yes. You can make a lot of money doing a lot of different businesses. But if this is your first business, you've never done anything entrepreneurial, I personally recommend you take whatever it is that you like to do and try to transition that into a small business. Scale it up. Learn the basics of business that apply regardless if you're breeding and selling fish, buying and reselling shoes, getting into real estate, or starting an appliance repair business. And then you could take those skills and go on to bigger and better businesses, okay? Now, before I end this video, let me show you guys something else. Apologize for the mess here. I still got to clean up that area a little bit more. But got a little overflow of shoes that couldn't fit upstairs. And, you know, it is what it is. But that washer and dryer that you just saw, the dryer works fine. The washing machine does have a minor issue with it. I'm going to take it up to my mentor, Mr. Mike Sneed. If you're not subscribed to his YouTube channel already, go subscribe to Save, Invest, Repeat on YouTube. Comment below his videos. Tell him JTS who sent you. And we're going to fix that washing machine. And then we're actually going to give it away at the event that we're planning. More information about that event will come out later on this week. And scroll down and check the upload date of this video, because if you're seeing this video after the fact, we might have already put out that information, and I don't want you guys to miss it. So I know a lot of you guys are interested in the appliance repair business and businesses that you can start for under $1,000 and make six figures with. That series is going to continue to go, but the plan for this washer and dryer, which was my personal washer and dryer, is to first get them both up running. Again, the dryer has no issues. Get the washing machine up and running, and then just make them look nice, and then we're going to give them away at our first event. And whatever you guys decide to do with them, you do with them. If you want to give them away to somebody else to use, give them away. If you want to sell them to somebody, sell them to somebody. If you want to take them to your house and install them somewhere, take them to your house and install them. It really doesn't matter to me. But they are a little bit older model washer and dryers. And since we are hosting our first event, which will teach you guys how to start a small appliance repair business, I think that it will be dope to give maybe one person the whole set, or maybe give two people one of each, so that once you have the skills needed to start this business, you have your first piece of inventory, you can immediately go out and put it on Craigslist, put it on your website, put it out there however you want to, and sell one of them and make your money back to cover your tools plus more to get your business started on a good note. One last thing about the tank, I don't know if you guys care about fish at all, so I'm trying to be minimalistic with the information. If anybody that watches my videos are into the aquarium hobby at all and got any advice about breeding fish, I am breeding zebra plecos. That's going to be the first species of fish that I'm going to breed. So in this tank alone, it's just going to be a bunch of zebra plecos that I'm going to work on breeding and then reselling them. It is very challenging to do. Anybody that knows about fish, and specifically that breed of fish, it is supposed to be a challenge in order to do that, but I'm willing to take on the challenge, and I look forward to working with these animals, figuring it out, and hopefully creating a successful breeding business for me. If you got information about breeding fish, put it in the comment section below. And if you guys have any trouble with turning your hobby into a small business and you want some other ideas about how you can make your hobby into a small business, comment your hobby in the description below, and either I'll get to it, or maybe somebody else that comments below will give you an idea of how you can take your hobby and make it into a small business that can make you a few extra dollars, and then depending on what your level of hustle is, maybe make you a lot of extra dollars. But to all my hustlers, stay hustling. JT Hustles, I'm gone.